Hello, hello, again to another Aga Color React, and today we'll be watching Top 10 Stars You Never Knew Were on Reality Shows from Miss Mojo. Let's just jump into and see something. And, I got this because obviously it's like stars and you want to know what kind of reality shows. And now when you think about reality shows, it's kind of like, I don't know, the Nova days, but the first cadre is from like really old stuff, and I don't think that it was even, that probably was even filmed before the reality show term was coined. So let's just go and see.
John Hamm.
Okay.
Waiter John Hamm, ladies and gentlemen.
Welcome to Ms. Mojo.
25, huh?
Today we're
How old is he now? It must be about 50?
Surprising reality show appearances made by celebrities before they were famous.
Where'd my salad go? Oh, I guess the best boy took it away.
It was not even here.
Number 10, Nicole Scherzinger.
Nicole Scherzinger.
That was meant to perform in front of people. I like to sing, I can dance, and just my life.
Long before she filled the airwaves with her powerhouse voice, Nicole Scherzinger was an aspiring performer looking for her big break. After leaving college to pursue music, Scherzinger auditioned for the reality series Pop Stars USA, as did actress Taryn Manning.
Body saying, let's go. Oh, oh, whoa. My heart is saying no.
I do not know this
American
girl.
Version
Who is
of
she
the
from?
Reality franchise hopes
or where is she
to find
from?
New musical talents, blowing everyone away with her stellar vocals. Scherzinger was plucked from a large pool of contestants.
And I will always love you.
Together with four other hopefuls, the future X Factor judge formed the band Eden's Crush. They produced a successful album, but disbanded when their label went under. Afterwards, Scherzinger joined the Pussycat Dolls, which scored a major hit with its first album.
The Lucky Lady is number 4.
Thank you all very much.
Number 9, Jaina Lee Ortiz.
Somebody there?
She's known for playing Andy on the Grey's Anatomy spin-off Station 19. But before that, actress Jaina Lee Ortiz was cutting her teeth on reality TV. In the late 2000s, she joined the cast of the competitive series Scream Queens.
That's a reality TV?
The VH1 show saw aspiring actresses striving against each other to win a part in the horror flick Saw 3D. Ortiz was part of the second season, and although she came in second place, she still took advantage of her newfound fame. She went on to star in Rosewood before Station 19. Sometimes being the runner-up has its perks.
What's your real name?
Soon it'll be Inmate 57798. You forgot to disguise your IP address when you sold Bobby's award. It led us right to you.
Number 8, The Miz.
The Miz is a character I created. He's a wrestling star, and he's ready for the big leagues.
I can't argue with that crap, man. I'm on the phone.
Coral, you just don't get it, do you?
Okay, so The Miz's early career on reality TV and isn't exactly
I don't
unknown,
know if you should start calling people... Nicole Scherzinger, I understand. John Hamm, I understand. I know who those people are. And that's when I kind of go for the someone being star. This is more like celebrity here. Not star. I don't even know who that guy is.
Helped launch a slew of future TV personalities, including Karamo Brown.
I say, oh, so you date... interracially.
Oh my gosh. That hairline was everything though. I love the reaction.
Okay. Miz caught a taste for fame and decided to pursue a career in wrestling. He joined the WWE, raking up several titles and championships. When he's not in the ring, Miz has often returned to his reality roots, appearing in series like Total Divas and Fear Factor.
I like to win. I love competition.
You're not doing it for the money, too.
Well, I'm getting there.
Number 7, Kesha. When pop star Kesha was only a teenager, her mother volunteered her family to appear on an episode of Fox's The Simple Life, starring Paris Hilton and Nicole Richie.
All the kids play music. We all meditate.
We're, I guess, what you'd call free spirits. You have to be really nice to the girls when they're here.
The former BFFs stayed with the fam while visiting Nashville and bonded with the team. She even helped the dynamic duo plan a Tennessee bride's bachelorette party.
Are you a cowboy?
No, I'm an investment banker, actually.
Do you like to dance?
I gotta save a horse, ride a cowboy, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
So if this was your
What's
mom,
going on here? I remember watching a few episodes of it when it came out, bro.
No one knew the future TikTok singer would become a big music sensation, but it would only be...
Did she just call her a TikTok singer? I know who Kesha is, and it's not just TikTok singer. What's going on in this world now? Because honestly, I'm thinking, like, Kesha is out there for years now, way before TikTok even... The makers of TikToks were had an idea of it, and it's just like... I don't know. I think my coffee is just making me grumpy, but... Kesha is someone whose songs you listen, you can hear in the radio. Even here in Ireland, even in Poland and stuff like that. That's what I call a star. Not someone who is in reality TV in years ago and no one else actually knows except people that actually just watched it maybe.
A few years later, that she once took or twice the world by storm.
In somewhere. Okay, I'm taking back everything. I totally forgot that that song is titled TikTok. That makes sense then, isn't it? Okay. Wow, that was terrible of me.
Working for Diddy would just open up the entire world for me.
Laverne Cox made her reality television debut on season one of VH1's I Want to Work for Diddy. Competing for an opportunity to work alongside music mogul Sean Combs, the future Orange is the New Black actress made a great impression on both the audience and the crew behind the scenes.
And Transform Me is a makeover show where me and two other transgender women, Nina Poon and Jamie Clayton, travel all over the country transforming women using what we've learned transforming ourselves.
After the show wrapped, she collaborated with the network to make her own reality show.
I actually have tears now in my eyes from that laughter because I made an idiot out of myself.
Giving the trans community a voice, and Cox became the first African-American transgender individual to appear in a series she created.
Transgender identity in terms of a makeover, it makes it a little bit more accessible. Because I think ultimately everyone's felt that the person they are on the inside sometimes isn't reflected on the outside.
Number 5, John Hamm. Best known for playing Don Draper on Mad Men, John Hamm wasn't always as smooth and as dapper as his TV persona.
What brings you in today?
We got tired of waiting for a cab, thought we'd buy a car.
In the 90s, the future Emmy winner was a contestant on the dating show The Big Date. Competing to go on a date with a lady named Mary, a floppy-haired Hamm proved that his flirtation still needed a bit of work.
Start off with some fabulous food, a little fabulous conversation.
What else fabulous, John?
End it with a fabulous foot massage for an evening of total fabulosity.
No.
After pitching a date idea that included food and a foot massage, Mary opted to go with another suitor. Clips of the episode were even edited into an episode of Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt, showing that Hamm has a good sense of humor about the whole thing.
He's the only one that said hello and shook my hand when he came through.
Oh, guys, you made a major mistake. He was the only one who came in and shook her hand, and that's why she picked you, Mark.
Number 4, Jeremy Renner. Marvel fans know him as Hawkeye, but did you know Jeremy Renner was once part of the Bravo universe? When he was an aspiring actor, Renner appeared on the network series The It Factor.
I really gotta pretend I don't know what's going on, especially with, you know, circumstances that have happened. You know, you really have...
He really changed, by the way.
Over 2 seasons, the show followed struggling actors' lives in New York City and Los Angeles. Other notable actors who appeared on Factor include Michaela Conlon and Godfrey.
You struggled a lot, right? You auditioned a lot. Got rejected a lot.
Of course, yeah.
What kept you going?
I knew since I was 19 what I wanted.
Years later, when asked about the show, Renner admitted that the experience was more personally helpful than it was professionally. But something tells us that he's doing just fine as he is.
Reshift my goals to something else. And then I struggled a lot in and out for that next decade.
Number 3, Beyoncé. Beat drop! I got the one of the biggest music stars.
I did not know that. Yes, and this is the star, the true star of this world.
Wasn't at the forefront of pop culture royalty. However, like most artists, she began working on creating a name for herself by seizing every opportunity that came her way. Working with an all-girl group known as Girls' Time, Beyoncé performed on the national talent show Star Search. In the end, the band did not win, but that didn't stop the future single lady singer from continuing to pursue her passion. She joined a long list of other superstars like Britney Spears and Christina Aguilera, who also lost the competition, but went on to achieve bigger and better things. Number 2, Lady Gaga. Before her music videos played on MTV, Lady Gaga, aka appeared on the network as herself.
The poker face singer appeared on MTV's 2005 show called Boiling Point, which puts unsuspecting subjects in irritating situations and then awards them $100 if they can basically keep their cool.
In the mid-2000s, she was on the reality prank show Boiling Point. The hidden camera style series took credulous people and set them up in frustrating scenarios to test how upset they would get.
Who puts that in their mouth? Would you put that in your mouth?
If they stayed calm, they won a monetary prize. During Germanata's prank, her meal disappears after she steps away from her table at a restaurant.
Unfortunately, Lady Gaga did hit her boiling point, forfeiting the prize money.
She was one of the people putting other people into that kind of thing, like she was part of the crew, and not that she was actually the contestant, you could say, I guess. Okay, what song is this?
But luckily, this was not the last we saw of the megastar. Look at me
now, I have to say something in regards of me knowing music and music videos. Up to like, I don't know, maybe 2006, I was quite up to date with music videos, but after that, not so much. I still listen to the music, I hear the music in the radio, I'm listening to the music on the Spotify, but I don't really have that much interest in music videos, so if I know the song, I probably don't know the video, like recent song. I know the videos from like 20 years ago, literally. That makes me kind of sad, because that makes me old.
To unveil our top pick, here are a few honorable mentions. David Giuntoli. Before solving supernatural crimes on Grimm, he was on Road Rules.
And I think I'm gonna do some crazy, crazy things. My name is Dave, I'm 22, and I'm from St. Louis, Missouri.
Heather Morris. This triple threat two-stepped from So You Think You Can Dance to Glee.
They've been inseparable throughout the auditions.
Ben and Heather, always together.
Lucy Hale. She's a pretty little liar, but before that, sang on American Juniors. Oh, yes, I will. Yes, I will. I'm gonna make you love me. Melissa Villaseñor. Future SNL star made an impression on America's Got Talent.
Hey, y'all, it's Miley Cyrus. What's up?
Okay.
What, Dad? No, I'm not gonna clean my room right now.
Chase Rice, now a country crooner, but once a runner-up on Survivor.
Chase.
Survivor's runs? Wow. Sure, I remember watching it when it came out, but I didn't realize it's still going.
You have the option to be notified
24 years later,
videos or all of them.
Wow.
If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications.
Number 1, Emma Stone. An Academy Award winner and movie star extraordinaire, Emma Stone has become one of Hollywood's finest actresses since she burst onto the scene in 2007's Superbad. While hustling from audition to audition as a teen, Stone earned her first TV credit as a contestant on VH1's In Search of the New Partridge Family. The premise for this unsold pilot was to assemble a brand new cast for a remake of the beloved 70s comedy. The future La La Land actress competed for the role of Laurie and showed off her vocal chops. In the end, the remake did not go ahead, and Stone continued to audition for project after project until she finally hit her stride and became the household name she is today.
Here's to the hearts that break. Here's to the mess we make.
Which one of these entries shocked you the most? Let us know in the comments.
All I want, my baby. Beyonce for sure.
Do you agree with our picks?
And Emma Stone too. I didn't know about that at all. And I didn't think... I don't know what I was thinking. But anyway, it was interesting to see. But like I said, the first two... I don't even know. Like, no, Nicole Scherzinger, I do know who that is. But the other two or three, there was just like... There were a few of them that I really don't know. And I wouldn't even call them stars. But a lot of them are. Emma Stone is a star. Beyonce is a star. John Hamm is a star. The guy from what's his name? The Graham Show. I only know because my mother watches that show, so that's the only reason why I would know who that is. But yeah, there's a lot of things that I would more call them celebrities than a star. But then I think a lot of times nowadays, celebrity and a star is just interchangeable when it shouldn't be. But that's my personal take on it. So thank you very much for watching. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.